Hi, we're working today on factory numbers, and specifically, we're going to be looking at finding all of the different factors of these four different numbers. First of all, a factor, if you'll remember, is a number that divides evenly into a given number. Factors always come with a pair, because, for example, if we look at 4, we know that we can have 1 times 4, to equal 4, or 2 times 2 to equal 4. So they're always going to come in a pair of two things that multiply together. And in this case, 1 is a factor, 4 is a factor, and then 2 is also a factor. So the number 4 has three factors, 1, 4, and 2. So getting to the process of finding the factors, what I like to do is I like to take and put a T underneath my number, and I always start with my first pair of 1 times the number, 1 times 24. And then on the left-hand side, I count up, and I find it's the corresponding pairs in the right-hand side. So 24 is an even number, so I know 2 will go into it. So I'll write 2 into my chart, and 2 times 12 equals 24, so I put its pair, 2 times 12 to get my 24. And then I keep counting up, I go to 3, and I think, well, 3 goes into 24 because 3 times 8 works. And I find my pair, 3 times 8 equals 24. And extend my T, count up to 4, and I think, well, 4 goes into 24, 4 times 6 equals 24. And count up to 5, 5 does not go into 24, count up to 6. Well, 6 is already in my chart. I've found a 6. As a pair with 4, so that means I am done. All of my factors of 24, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24 are my factors of 24. So doing the same thing with 60, I create my T. 1 times 60 is always my first. It's even, so I go 2, and then the factor pair for 2 is 30. 2 times 30 equals 60. 3 also goes into 60. 3 times 20 goes into 60. 4 goes into 60. That's 4 times 15. So you're just finding your pairs. And I'm just thinking, okay, 60 divided by 4 equals 15. Does it go in evenly? 5, 60 divided by 5 equals 12. So 5 is a factor. If I go to 6, 60 divided by 6 is 10. So that is a factor. If I go to 7, 60 divided by 7 is not going to work. 7 times 9 is 63. So it's not going to go in evenly. 60 divided by 8 doesn't work because 8 times 8 is 64, so it won't go into 60. We've already said 7 times 9 doesn't work. And then we go to 10, and 10 is already on our list, so we are done. All of our factors, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 12, 15, 20, 30, and 60. Again, you know you're done once you start counting and you find a number that's already on your list. So let's go to 35. 35 is 1 times 35, so we always start with that. It is not even, so I don't put 2 on my list. 35 divided by 3, if you remember your test for divisibility for 3, you add up your digits. 3 plus 5 equals 8. 8 is not divisible by 3, so 35 is not divisible by 3. I go up to 4. Well, anything that's even I can ignore, because if 2 doesn't go into it, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 doesn't go into it. So anything even at this point, I don't have to worry about. So 5, does 35 divided by 5 work? And it does. 35 divided by 5 is 7. I said I don't have to worry about 6, and 7 is already on my list. So this particular number just has 4 factors, 1, 5, 7, and 35. And then 19, we know it's 1 times 19. It's not even, so we can ignore all of the evens, 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. 1 plus 9 is 10, so it's not 3. 5 doesn't. 7, no. 9 doesn't, 11 doesn't work, 13 doesn't work, 15, 17, 19 is on our list. So this is just 1 in 19. 19 is a prime number, if you remember that from the sieve of Eratosthenes. So that is it, finding all of the factors of a number. Use your T. On the left-hand side, you simply count up. On the right-hand side, you are finding the pairs of your numbers along the left. Good luck. Have a great day.